Master Gardeners, here I am in Delta, Pennsylvania, in hot pursuit of the spotted lanternfly egg cases. In Delta, these insects have moved from they started originally in 2014 in the Berks County area, and they've been expanding the quarantine region, and the quarantines are not being effective. And now here they have jumped over the Susquehanna River, and here they are in York County. So I'm in the Delta region, and one of my coworkers said that she had egg cases in her trees and around her shed. So what's interesting about this particular leafhopper is it has laid eggs, not just on trees, but they're laid all on this potting shed. And we're gonna show you where they're underneath of the shelves. And I even have a piece of wood here we'll be able to zoom in on to show you the egg cases on the corner here. See these gray wax covered mounds? That doesn't look much like an egg case, does it? But in fact, that female has laid a number of eggs underneath of there, and she covers it with this gray waxy substance to keep them protected during the winter months. I'm here today with a oil sprayer. We're using it as a ovicide to try to suffocate these egg cases. They're going to be hatching soon, and you can use oil-based, I'm going to lay this down. You can use, here's what the insect looks like. If you want to see what he is, he's a little red-winged little guy. That's what the insect looks about, what, almost 2 inches in width, really very pretty little insects. So here's the region that the insect is now located in, all of Pennsylvania, down through Maryland, even located down in Virginia now. All these areas are quarantined. So if you happen to be hauling plant material out of Pennsylvania down into Maryland, you need to make sure that you know what these egg cases look like, because by law, you have to make sure there's no adult insects on your plant material or any egg cases. So what is the preferred host of this insect? The unusual thing about this insect is, number one, is it lays eggs on stationary objects. Where is the logic in that? If you were a mother, why would you lay baby eggs on rocks and shed shelves? Doesn't seem very practical, does it? But it sure does help for distribution of your children. Because this insect lays eggs on quarry rock, that's how it got here into the Pennsylvania region. And what's happening is, in the railways throughout Pennsylvania, we're finding the insect is being spread because it's being transported by different cargo items. And another thing, it enjoys the tree of heaven, which is often found in railroad areas. It lives, the tree of heaven likes dry, poor, disturbed soils, and that's the kind of habitat that you find along railways. So since that's where the tree is, that's another plant that the insect really loves. And so Pennsylvania has been extensively spraying insects along the rail lines because there's so many tree of heaven. I'm going to show you that tree of heaven in a second. So why do we dislike this insect? One, it's going to feed on our trees, and it's going to suck the phloem, the sap out of the phloem. And that's not necessarily the bad part, is it's the nuisance part of it. If you're planning a spring wedding in 2022, you might do some homework to find out if there's spotted lantern flies in your area, because they come in such great numbers, and they're hoppers. They hop around the ground and they hop on people. They're harmless, but they do hop on things, and they could be hopping on your attendees to your wedding and your outdoor parties. So you need to realize, even though they're harmless, they're quite the nuisance. Not only great numbers and hopping are the problems, and then they suck juice out of your trees. So you're going to say, well, what kind of trees do they get on? I'll make sure I don't have any of those. There's such a wide host range. The insect is originally from Asia. And once it, now that it's here in the United States, it's got 60 to 70 species of plants on which it will climb up and suck the juice out of. So there's really no definite fact. We know there's certain maples that they tend to prefer, but don't think that you're going to solve the problem that way. Now, what can you do about them? So we're here today. There's an oil-based spray. If you've ever used horticultural oils before, I put a little sample in here. We've mixed it up in the sprayer. We're going to spray her spotted lanternfly egg cases today in an effort to try to suffocate them. You can do this during the months of March and April. And when you spray them late in the winter like this, or early spring, you're more likely to kill them after they've already endured the cold winter months. And so that's one approach. The second approach is, once they hatch, they can be sprayed with a general purpose garden spray like a pyrethrin. They die pretty easily. So you don't have to think, well, how will we kill such a big insect? They give way pretty easily. So are there natural things you can spray? You might try some of those natural products. We don't fully know just yet. One of the most important approaches is people are injecting their trees with chemicals, systemic chemicals. And those are pretty effective at removing, and that's one of the approaches the USDA is using. So come on over and take a look, because we came here to look at the egg cases. My eyeglasses are all covered with rainwater. Let me get them cleaned off. And we're gonna look underneath of the bench here. Here's one set. Look at the little gray. You can sort of see the lines. See the little lines inside of there somewhat? I'm not so sure that the camera can pick that up. But let's go to the right and see. There's another one over there. There's another. Look at that little case underneath there. Oh, good view there. Oh, yeah. That's it. Look down here. Farther down. Where are they? There they are, up there. Look up under the bench. And even as you get farther down, there's even more egg cases. Down there at the very end. Look at it. One, two. So they're everywhere. Why do you think she has so many here in her shed area? Let's look over in this region. Guess what this tree is? This is the evil tree of heaven, Atlantis altissima. And so it's right over top of her chicken pen. And that's the reason she's probably got so many egg cases in her yard. So the question is, what's she gonna do with this spotted, with this tree of heaven? Because we know it doesn't have to have a tree of heaven, but it does prefer tree of heaven. One of the approaches that can be taken, what the USDA has been doing, is injecting them with that systemic herbicide so that insects that feed on this tree would be killed when they hatch and feed. In the latter stages of the development, the later nymphs, they go to woody plants. In the early stages, you're gonna find your spotted lanternfly. And let me tell you, they're very pretty little insects, so you ought to do some homework to know what the little baby ones look like. They're black with dots and they're red with dots, so learn what those stages look like. In those young stages, they're feeding on a lot of perennials and things. At the stages of 3 and 4, in the latter stages, they're feeding on these woody plant trees. What she can do is have this injected, and when the insects are feeding, it would kill them. But the other concern is she has a party of little chickens that live behind here, and we're concerned about, okay, well, what would really the best approach be to make sure her chickens are safe? So those are some big questions. Today we're here to treat just the egg cases with oil. If you know that you have spotted lanternfly or you think you see them this summer, you need to report it to your county extension office, or you can go to the Home and Garden Information Center in Maryland and go on their website. There's all kinds of information, and you can report through that agency as well. There's some links on there. So there you go, Master Gardeners. Now you know. Here we are at Delta, Pennsylvania. They're loaded with spotted lanternfly.